I will explain you how to stand and sit and lay down to save your belly and bottom muscles healthy and not increase the problems with the bottom muscles and abdominal muscles. So very important for us, for women, to stand correctly. Observe my pelvis. When we're afraid so much, our anus squeezing and it's going a little bit forward, like it's trying to hide this area, and it's going forward. It's not good position for our bottom muscles. So we adjusting it, and also opposite, when you overbend your lower back, it's also create the tension in the bottom muscles to be able to relax it and also keep the organs and on the place. You need to move your pelvis back and forward and find straight position. It's really, really important for our to avoid some gynecologic problem. And if we overbend, our belly going forward and it's look even bigger, our belly bigger, and it can increase the prolapse of organs. So our pelvis a little bit forward and not overbended. Then we pay attention on our chest. When we not confident, when we afraid, we feel worried, we closing our chest, like us trying to escape. So when you feel that you feel some emotional state of your mind, you're just returning your attention to your posture and start with opening your chest, that your heart going forward first, then your head. So you're opening your chest, and it's very good for our chest, that it's not sitting down, it's not aging and become like older. So you're showing your beautiful chest and opening your heart, and you can breathe it this way better, because when you're slouching, the diaphragm on tension squeezed, and you cannot inhale and exhale fully, so your belly not moving fully, you're not receiving a lot of blood circulation and oxygen to your belly and to recover your internal organs. And also observe your shoulders, that they're not closed like this and not super back, so it's relaxed, but over the pelvis over the heels, and head over the shoulders, head, shoulders, hip and heels, one line. And every second person now I see and observing in my classes that they bring head a little bit forward, and so much tension here because we're using so much telephone, gadget, playing, reading. So our head a little bit forward, it's affect to our face muscles. So we become older, we can have second chin, and it's also affect, there is tissue which going to the bottom muscles, it's affect to the bottom muscles. So please return your chin a little bit in and head on the place, not forward, so your neck can be relaxed, and the blood will come to your brain and you will receive oxygen. So a little bit back, but be sure that you are not over bending neck. So the top of head stretching up, chin in, like a Jalandhara Bandha in yoga. And again, check head, chest, pelvis and heels. You are straight, and when you straight, your emotional state also balancing quickly. And you just remind yourself, when you feel that you're in a victim position or are not confident, you're afraid, just tell to yourself, look at the mirror and open your shoulders, return your head back, open your chest and tell to yourself, I'm in a straight position, I'm in a position of my power. It will help you to return back. And when you're lying, you feel more confident, more aligned. And when you're walking, first your chest going forward, then your head, not like this, and pelvis like this or like this, to create more tension on your lower back, belly and pelvis. So second part, how we sit down, because it's also affect our bottom muscles. Important that you are not crossing your leg, because it's squeezing blood circulation in the sexual organs. You sit straight and not over bent, lower back, hyperlordosis, not like this, and not like this. And this telephone is a lot of people sitting, you know, it can create gynecological problems, and you need to sit on the sitting bones, on your bottom muscles, feel it. And your pelvis straight, and your chest also not like this, it's up, and shoulders relaxed, not like this. When you're not breathing, your shoulders will be up, so you're relaxing them. You can move one head also a little bit back and up. Also important part, when we lay down, to pay attention, especially when you're pregnant or have weak bottom muscles, you have diastasis, and these muscles a little bit not well after pregnancy, during the pregnancy, not recommended to lay down like this. And stand up like this. So you avoid this to not create more tension to the bottom muscles, because when you're pregnant, your baby, weight of the baby pushing to the bottom, and tension increasing. So take care of yourself and please lay down through the side. You can use your elbow, go down, and then lay down, and then you can turn to your spine and return the same way through the side first. And this way you can control with your arms and abdominal muscles not over tense and not create the pressure to the bottom. Wish you health and straight position.